wonderful toy. Rama, we had a good time at your house.
I'm glad. Very happy to hear.
Yeah. She made chole and bitter gourd and free of gluten pizza bhiksha. Right? Nice. Very nice. What to do now? Another katho round two. Round two. Yes?
Yes.
Om. Sahana bhavatu.
Sahana bhunaktu. Saha viryam karavavahai.
Tejasvinavadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai. Om shanti shanti shantihi. पुरमेकादशद्वारम्
पुरमेकादशद्वारम्
अजस्यावक्रचेतसः
अजस्यावक्रचेतसः
अनुष्ठायन शोचति
अनुष्ठायन शोचति
विमुक्तश्च विमुच्यते
विमुक्तश्च विमुच्यते
एतद्वैतत्
एतद्वैतत्
Yeah. So I think we just have to see the last quarter. Vimuktascha vimuchyate. So na shochati anushthaya anushtha we saw very clearly. So this is the whole discussion of the person, the purusha, in the indweller of the body, mind, sense complex. We saw the whole imagery. The immune system is the defense mechanism of this kingdom. The Raja is the Puraswami, correct? Mm-hmm. Who is the Puraswami? The indweller, the one who is dwelling inside this body, so to speak, for whom this whole kingdom is there. And the eyes, ears, etc. are the sentries, the spies that bring back information. You know, there goes chocolate. They bring back the information. And the nose confirms it, the eyes see it. And then the mind, you know, is the one, the chief minister, you know, is the buddhi. And the supervisor is of these sentries is the mind. But usually what does the mind do? Go after the sentries instead of corralling them and saying, not now. Kathopanishad class is going on. Sit down and listen. No matter how, whatever delicious smells may be coming, ignore. The mind should say that. But what does the mind do? I think we will go. Never mind all that. Let's go. And then what happens? The buddhi is the last resort where this thing has to take place, where a certain break has to take place. B-R-A-K-E has to be put. If buddhi also is not available, then the whole thing goes down the drain. That's why it says anushthayana shochati. It's not enough to just have this wonderful, verse that talks about this city with various apertures with which to contact the jagat. And then the objects of contact are very, very, what's the word for it? Appealing, beguiling, tempting. And they threaten to take this person away, even though, and then, because the person is taken away from oneself, the truth of oneself, where does the person go? The person falls into a pit of all kinds of finitude and gets identified with them also. Gets identified with the finite and then therefore what? Shochati. Even though the person is, the truth of this indweller is avakra and ajaha. you know, avakra najaha. Even though it's a this luminous being with uninhibited luminosity, you know, completely free of all distortions and unborn, the indweller of all, not knowing that, shochati, anushthaya, making this a reality through shravanam, mananam, nididhyasanam. And Adi Shankara in the Bhashya also acts dhyatva jnana purvakam. Dhyatva means having meditated upon that before the knowledge. So when do you meditate? Before the knowledge, during the knowledge, after the knowledge. Whole life you make a meditation. So then na shochati, there is nothing to be sorrowful about. Why? That's how I told you last time. He brings in na bhaya iksha asti. You know, the shoka happens because there is fear. Fear and, shoka. What is shoka? Grief. Yeah, grief and fear are just very much married together. If one is there, definitely the other one is not too far away. Yeah, if fear is there, grief will come. If grief is there, fear will definitely, you know, come through the back door. So therefore, this whole thing is beautifully, you know, talked about. And then what? Vimuktascha, you know, vimuchyate. So then, na shochati. Na shochati means what? Does not come to grief. And does not come to grief when? Only in the morning. In the evening, it's very hard for this person. No. At any time, does not come to grief. Usually, so, you know, even the most depressed person, even the person who is subject to severe depression, has moments of happiness, enjoys, is able to enjoy moments of happiness. They will say, I'm not a morning person. Mornings are horrible. By evening, I come alive and I'm okay. And some other people will say, morning, I'm fine. Evening, I feel sad. You know, so like this, na shochati doesn't mean, you know, at a particular time. Timelessly na shochati, having understood one's own timelessness, timelessly na grivati, na shochati, does not grieve. You know, it does not have shoka. And so at any time, not in the morning, not in the afternoon, not in the evening, not today, not tomorrow, not in young age, not in old age, not certainly not in middle age, at no time is there even a shadow, a lesha of grief. And therefore what? If there is no shoka, there is vimuktihi. What is vimukti? What is mukti? What is mukti? Now mukta is liberated. Muktihi, liberation. Vimuktihi, a special mukti while alive. A divine dispensation, question mark? No. I told you, Bhagavan is not giving out moksha like that. Touchless, what is that? Wireless, touchless dispenser in the some you know, remote thing you put out and then lotion comes out. And so here, you know, what is that? Some Amrita potion comes out. This is not any potion. This Upanishad potion is, if it can be called a potion, is a potion that gets rid of all your notion. That is the potion. That is only potion, that is the Upanishad. It gets rid of all your notions from beginning to end. I'm no good, I'm an idiot, I'm all right, the other one is an idiot. All these notions. I wish I was married. This is what the lament of the unmarried person. The single person. I wish I had someone. And then the one who has someone, how to get rid of this fellow. You know, that is the other lament. And the person who doesn't have children says, oh, I just missed out the, what is it called, some clock. They keep talking of some clock. Some clock has ticked. Biological clock, yeah. Bio clock has ticked off and has left me ticked off. So there is all these regrets. And then the person who has children, keeps looking for adoption notices. Who wants? How can I give it away? You know, put a little bow on the head, put it in the basket and then leave it somewhere at someone's doorstep. Ring the bell and run away. This is what the person who has children, you know, many a times wants to do. Is not happy with the children they have. Oh, you know, how is your son? You know, Ravi's your daughter. He's okay, but not okay. Always some complaint. How are you? This is the whole thing. Everything is one big whine. You know, this is all complain. How much to complain? This is the scenario of, you know, the person who is not avimukta, not vimukta. Yeah. So muktaha means muktaschet nashochati. So the nashochati has to be connected to vimuktaha. When vimuktaha, ihaiva, asmin janmani, in this body, eva, in this body, while alive. Our freedom is not after death. After death, what freedom? Who knows where you go and whether you like it and what freedom? If you cannot be free here, you cannot be free there. Right? Wherever there is, let us say heaven. Let's be positive. Let's say heaven. Something I'm allergic to here. I don't know what.
The flower.
Excuse me. It's not the flower. I don't know what it is. We'll figure it out. All right. So, vimuktaha means no shoka at all. Because if the shoka has not left this body and you leave the body, then what you carry along with you?
Desires.
And shoka. Shoka goes for the ride for free in the sukshma sharira. It doesn't pay anything. It doesn't pay taxi fare, nothing. It goes. First, let us be positive and say one goes to heaven. So this fellow goes to heaven. And then what? Does not like heaven. Finds fault with the lawns in heaven. Yeah. The grass is not evenly cut. It's not, you know. And there are ways of cutting grass. People in Eugene don't know anything. They let it grow taller than themselves. And nobody complains. In the East Coast, you should see in places like Washington, D.C., there are different ways of cutting grass. I never knew that there were so many ways of cutting grass until I went and stayed in D.C. There is the diagonal cut. So everything goes, the riding mower comes, of course with the rider in it, and goes just diagonally. So if the lawn is, you know, let's say the lawn is this big, so you have these diagonal cut marks. And then there is a diamond cut, diagonal, and then this side also. Then there is a square cut, and then some kind of, all kinds of cuts. And then in these rich neighborhoods, you have these, you know, spick and span all their lawns. I mean, here, you know, these fellows, they just go to on one thing. They don't know anything in Eugene. Should go to D.C. to see the lawns. Yeah. And, you know, oh, feathers?
Uh-huh.
I'm allergic to feathers? Apparently.
That's...
Come on. No, that's okay. It's just intriguing because as soon as I went upstairs, I was fine.
Uh-huh.
And
mostly in the bag. So when she comes in, she gets a nice...
All right. So now... so... Excuse me. So, we have this whole science of lawn cutting, correct? And so this person dies and goes to heaven and finds fault with the lawn. Maybe in heaven they are like Eugene. They just don't, they let it just keep raining. In between the raindrops, they cut one sprig of grass and come back. Who knows? But this is, you know, finds fault with a lawn, finds fault with a garden statues, you know, Lord Dakshinamurti, finds fault with everything, and then demands to see Indra. You call this landscape? I know better landscape from where I came from. And Indra looks at a paricharaka, a heavenly sevak, a divine sevak, and says, send him back there, because he's missing that so much. Anger has not gone. And then what? Grief also hasn't gone. look at another scenario, goes along with the grief and then is sad in heaven because someone cut him off, someone blocked his view of Bhagavan. He was having nice sayujyam, meaning becoming one with Bhagavan, and then what? And then this, you know, basketball player came and sat in front of him, and he was trying to play dodgeball to see Bhagavan this side, and that fellow also would go like this, then he would go like this, this fellow also would go like this. So therefore this whole thing is connected. So, you know, Ashokaha Chet Vimuktaha, you know, Ashokas Chet Vimuktaha, Na Shochati is equal to Vimuktihi. And why the V is used? The V is used to show a sense of the mukti being final, in the sense of finality, you know. V has many meanings. Sometimes it means from which it has departed. Vimuktaha not means vigataha muktihi asmat. No, not from whom mukti has departed. No, from whom shoka has departed. Therefore, completely free, free of all kinds of what? You know, notions, sorrow, fear, anger, dread, everything. And therefore, it lives freely in the jagat, encounters anything and is unaffected. Except perhaps for some feathers. So is unaffected. Body may be affected. Mind is not affected. Buddhi is not affected. The indweller is not affected. You know? And even if the mind is affected, the indweller is not affected. Like in dementia, etc. The mind can be affected, but the indweller is free. Avakraha. You know? The chetas is avakraha, the chit is avakra. And so vimuktaha, vimuktascha, and having been freed in this life, then after the body is dropped, then is bound, correct? No. Continues to be free. Vimuktaschet, vimuchyate. Vimuchyate means after leaving this body, does not return to another body. Because the work in the world is complete when you have this knowledge, and when you are not having sadness. When one is not having sadness, no fear means no reason to come back. Because it's the sadness and the unfulfilled incompleteness of the jiva due to what? The insecurity, which is due to self-ignorance. And the self-ignorance morphs into self-non-acceptance, self-criticism, self-judgment, etc., etc., etc. All these are recipes for shoka. And so here, there is no shoka. And such a person, you know, the body dies away, and the person was already worshipped as Brahman, continues to be Bhagavan-like inspiration for others to follow after that person passes away. Vimuktaschet vimuchyate. Now, an important disclaimer. What is that disclaimer? The disclaimer is that after reading this mantra and enjoying the bhashya of it, enjoying its commentary, one might start to think that Atma is only in my body and my mind, not yours. Yours, I don't know who you are possessed by, but not Atma. Atma is only, excuse me, Atma is only in my body. My body is pervaded by this Atma, which is avakra, which is, you know, ashokaha, and which is vimuktaha. My body is free of being what? Filled with all kinds of problems and everything. So if Atma is occupying my body, what is occupying your body? I don't want to know. You know? I don't want to know. So this is a kind of a wrong conclusion one can come. What is the correct conclusion? It's all one Atma, but Atma is in every body, not just one body, correct? Yeah. Atma is not a single puravartin. Puravartin means pure vartate iti puravartin. So the one who remains in the city. Which city? My city. No. In all cities. This Atma is all pervasive. So that one doesn't go away with the erroneous conclusion that this Atma belongs to only one thing, one body-mind-sense complex. Then, therefore, the next verse is commenced. Very beautiful verse, very wonderful. Hamsashuchisat. Hamsashuchisat. Hamsashuchisat.
Hamsashuchisat.
Vasurantarikshasat.
Vasurantarikshasat.
Hota Vedishat.
Hota Vedishat.
Hota Vedishat.
Hota Vedishat.
Atithir Duronasat.
Atithir Duronasat.
Mrishat.
Mrishat.
Varasat.
Varasat.
Ritasat.
Ritasat.
Vyomasat.
Vyomasat.
Abja Goja Ritaja.
Abjagojarita
cha Adrija
Adrija
Ritam Brihat
Ritam Brihat
Hamsashuchisat
Hamsashuchisat.
Yeah, when I'm saying it, I'm saying sat because I'm, breaking the sandhis. That's the only difference. Hamsashuchisat
Hamsashuchisat.
It's the Swamiji, we don't have lots of these shushas together in English.
Shuchi.
Shuchi.
Sat.
Sat.
Shuchi sat. No, only when I'm breaking it up. It's fine. It does, but I'm breaking up the sandhis for you.
I see.
Yeah, yeah. I'm breaking up the sandhis. Shuchi sat. Shuchi sat. Yeah. I'm breaking up the sandhis. You can say shuchishat if it's easier. Hamsa shuchishat. Say that, yeah.
Hamsa shuchishat.
Hamsa.
Hamsa.
Shuchi.
Shuchishat.
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 Ah, you got it. Shuchishat, 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 shuchishat. Ah, shuchi shat, shuchi shat, hamsa shuchi shat,
hamsa shuchi shat,
ah, vasurantarikshasat,
vasurantarikshasat,
hota vedishat,
hota vedishat,
atithir duronasat,
atithir duronasat,
drishat,
drishat,
varasat,
varasat,
ritasat,
ritasat,
vyomasat,
vyomasat,
abjagoja ritaja,
abjagoja ritaja,
adrija,
adrija,
ritam brihat,
ritam brihat.
Yeah, very beautiful verse, beautiful mantra. So let's see the meaning. And hamsaha means hanti. Hanti doesn't mean kill. Here gachati. Hanti gachati iti hamsaha. Gachati means what? Gachati means what?
Goes.
So hamsaha means that which goes. Where does it go? Shuchau. In a clean place it goes. What is this clean place? Space. That which goes in space is called shuchishat. What goes in space?
The
What goes in space? All sorts of things. Here we are referencing the sun. The sun goes in space. You know, Shuchau here is Divi, you know, in space. And this sun that goes in space. Hum Saha Shuchishat. So we are not talking of the sun. We are talking of that which makes the sun do what it does. The word sat is double meaning. See, first you take sad, we have to take all the meanings, very nice, that's why this verse is so beautiful, very beautiful. It's okay. Yeah, it's all right. No problem. You'll be all right. So, Ham Saha Shuchi Shat. Sat, we have to take also Sad. What does Sad mean? Sidati. Sidati means what? Sits. That which sits, you know, in that which moves in space. Sits. Shuchau Sidati. That which sits in that which moves in space, which is the sun. That which sits in the sun. Mm. One meaning. Very nice. And that which is, we can take the next meaning, not as sad, Sidati. The other one is sat. What is sat?
True existence.
Is. The presence. So the presence in the sun is what? Sat. That Atma, Atmana Sidati, in the form of Atma, it occupies that which is the sun, which is called the sun. And in the form of Sat, it lends its existence to the very being of the sun. Beautiful. All the Sats have this double meaning. That which sits in that which moves in space, that which is the truth, which is the very existence, which is the content, which is the very presence in that, which gives the very being to that sun itself. Because the sun gives being to everything in the jagat. That's why it starts with this. The sun, because of the sun life is, because of the sun this whole, you know, earth is, right? The whole solar system is. And so just like the sun gives this being to this whole prithivi, to this whole earth, it gives life, it gives being. Similarly, the Atma, which is I, gives the very being to the sun. Beautiful. Hamsa Shuchishat. Shuchishat. Then the next one, Vasuhu. Vasayati iti Vasuhu. Vasayati means lives, dwells, indwells, pervades, vyapnoti. Pervades everything. Where does it vasayati? Where does it vyapnoti? Antarikshe. Antariksha is a very funny word. It means between the heaven and earth, in space. Vayuhu. So we have the sun. The next one is what? Vayusat. Yeah. Vasuhu. Antariksha sat. Very beautiful verse. Vayuhu. So it sits in the Vayu. What sits? Atma. Sits as the Vayu, in the Vayu. In the Vayu, Sidati. As the Vayu, Sat. Beautiful. Double meaning. It's a Upanishadic double entendre. Very nice. Sidati means sits, meaning lends its very being, Sat. Sidati, actually because of it, you know, it sits there. Meaning, if you want to take the base level meaning, just like the Puraswami is sitting in the city. Similarly, the Atma is not just in this body-mind-sense complex, but in every body, and every body, the body of the sun, what do you find? When you open it, Atma is sitting quietly inside. See, Dati. And then, Atma is sitting very softly, without making a noise, quietly it is sitting. And then when you open the very being of Vayu, who is sitting? Atma is sitting. That's one meaning of Sat. Then what do you take in this meaning? You take the verb Sad to sit, literally. And then you can take it metaphorically as well. You can take it as Sat, the very presence of the sun is in the form of the Atma. As the Atma, the sun manifests. As the very being of the Vayu, the Atma manifests. As the very Atma of the Vayu, Atma manifests. So the Vayu is nothing but the Sat of that Atma. The presence of that Atma is Vayu. Vasurantarikshasat. What's the next one?
Hota
Vedi Sat. Very nice. Hota means fire here. So we have done the sun. What's the next one? Vayu. Fire. Hota is fire. Hotru. Hota is also the name of a Rig Vedic Pandit. Hota. What is the, you know, Yajurvedic Pandit? Called? Adhvaryu. Adhvaryu. Swami Vedic Pandit is called Udgata. Yeah. So, like this, we have all the names for the Purohits. So, here, Hota means fire. Vedi is the Yajna Kunda where the fire is. Yeah. Vedi, that you know, that three steps and that quadrangle in which the fire is offered, that is called Vedi. Hota Vedi Sat. Yeah, very beautiful. So here the fire, the very being of the fire is what? Atma. And that Atma is in the Vedi. And what is the Vedi here? The Vedi is metaphorically the earth. Because that one was Antariksha, this one was in the space. And then that was in between the space and the earth, and this one is now finally grounded in the earth. So the Vedi becomes a metaphor for the earth. Literally also you can take that the very presence of the fire in the Vedi is nothing but the Atma. In the fire, Atma sits. And the one meaning, Sidati, you know, Hotra Rupena Sidati, Atmana Sidati, or you can take, you know, the very presence of the fire is nothing but the presence of the Atma. The very presence of the Atma is, you know, the Atma is manifest as the fire. The Atma lends its existence and its very being to the name and the form called fire. You know, and the name and the form called the earth as well. Hota Vedi Sat. Hota Vedi Sat. Atithir Durona Sat. Atithir Durona Sat. Durona or Drona is a pot. Kumbha. Kalasha. Durona. Atithihi is a code word for Soma juice. Soma juice is like this, there is another one which these people here, it comes from a cactus and then it's a ritual drink, it's intoxicating but it's only done in ceremony.
Peyote.
Yeah, sounds like coyote. Yeah, that is, so peyote, like that, there was, it is now, it is now gone, extinct, because perhaps they over-harvested it, we don't know. Or perhaps it just is not meant for us to have in Kali Yuga, because it definitely would be abused. So there was a plant whose juice, the leaf juice was pressed, you know, and pressing the soma juice was itself done with a lot of prayers, and that was offered to the fire, and then that was boiled and drunk raw. And then the people used to have some visions. you know, and they used to guide the people with those visions. So this is what is was in all the Soma Yajna, this Soma juice was very much a important ingredient. So then it is called Atithi, because like a guest, it is used sparingly. Yeah, the guest, if they come and stay forever, then they are not guest. It's a pest, correct? This is a very fine line between guest and pest. So therefore, in order to be guest, you should be hardly seen. Wait till you're invited, and then don't overstay your welcome. You stay for a little while and go away, and then you always leave the people longing. When are we going to see you again? When are we going to see you again? What's going to happen? You know, you really need to come back. When are you visiting us again? That is the way to go, correct? That is the guest dharma. The guest cannot say, you know, in India we have some very, you know, awkward situations. Especially a decade back, now people have become rude. But one or two decades back, somebody would come. You know, sometimes they would write a letter, sometimes they would not write. And then because the guest is treated with such respect, you are not allowed to ask, how long are you going to stay? You can never ask that. How long are you coming for? Here they will ask even before they come. Don't come, they will say. You can never say don't come. Even if you have plans, you cancel the plans and you wait for them to come. Yeah. And then because it's a guest is a metaphor for everything that comes in life. If I can't handle a guest, what can I handle, you know? Because I'm always flying off the handle. So therefore, the guest is, you don't ask. And then you try to count the suitcases, and then from... when they bring in the suitcases, then you try to count the suitcases and then see, you know, kind of have a anumana. You infer, you know, two suitcases, maybe 2 weeks. Oh my God. And so then, but you're not allowed to ask. So you say things like, oh, that's too bad that you won't stay for my daughter's graduation, which is 3 weeks away. So, you know, you make it kind of vague. My child's graduation, you won't be there. And they will say, no, I'll be there. Don't worry. Then that plan has gone fut. You can't, you can't ask like that. Then you will take something further down. You know, a good friend of ours there, you know, some, they are getting married in, you know, in 2 months. They are very fun people. Right now they are in India, but I wish next time, you know, I'll introduce. No, I'll be here for that. Then the person, the host, starts to get alarmed. But you cannot ask. You see? So the guest has, this guest dharma is very interesting. So like this Soma juice, which only comes into the pot to be shared only when it's invited, ritually invoked. That's why it is called Atithihi. Durona Sat. And so what is in this Durona? Some intoxicating substance? No. So Atma is sitting in the pot. Soma pot. Soma pot is Atma pot. In fact, pot itself is Atma, Soma is Atma, everything is Atma. But for the time being, we'll make a difference between the carrier and the carried. So the carrier is the pot, just like this body is a big pot. So like this, the Soma juice pot, Kalasha, Kumbha, Durona. In the Durona, like a nicely invited, infrequent guest, the Soma sits. And the Soma symbolizes Atma, or the truth of the Soma sitting in the pot is nothing but Atma. The being of the Soma is the being of the Atma. In fact, Soma is nothing but Atma. Atma is not Soma. Ah. One meaning, this particular phrase has 2 meanings. So, by the next meaning, this is bad, sorry. The next version is very nice. Durona means house, metaphorically. And then the Atithi, just like when the Atithi sneaks into the house. And who is this Atithi coming for which you changed all your plans? Nothing but Atma. So just like the Atithi sits in the house, or like the Soma juice sits in the pot, Durone tishtati, durone sidati, athava, athitivat, like even the Atithi coming in the Durona Grihe, in somebody's house. So the idea is that, you know, here, you know, whether you take the meaning Siddhati, sits in, or frequents, or is the, or you take is the truth of, is the very presence of, either way, the incidental nature of the Atma visiting various locales, so to speak, and the all-pervasive yet incidental nature of the connection between the Atma and the Jagat is described in this particular one. Because Atithihi Durona Sat. So whether you take the Atithi as the guest in the house, or whether you take it as Soba juice inside the pot, a temporary occurrence, correct? So there is the paradox here. The permanent Atma, the limitless Atma, the Nitya Atma is temporarily making its home in all Anitya locales, as it were. The locale is also Atma, but here we are making one point that it is the truth of all bodies. It's not just sitting in my body, it is in the sky, in the ocean, in the sun, in everything, you know. Atithir Durona Sat. Nrishat. Yeah. Nru means what? Nru means human being. Yeah. Nripaha. Nrinam Pati iti Nripaha. Pati Rakshati. That which protects all the Nrus is Nripaha. Pibati also is paha, but you cannot say nrinam pibati. It doesn't make any sense. not a cannibal. So nrinam paati iti nripaha. That's how you get the word nripaha. So here, but when you say somapaha, somam pibati, somapaha. Yeah. So here, nrishat, nrinam sat. Nrinam Siddhati iti Nrishat, or Nrinam Sat, the truth of all human beings, Manushyanam Siddhati, which sits in all human beings, and that how it sits was elucidated very nicely in the last verse. So, Manushyanam Siddhati sits in all beings, all human beings. And then what? What's the other meaning? Is the very being of all humans. The human being. In the word human being, the being is Atma. Atmana tishthati. Very beautiful. The very being in the word human being is Atma alone. And then what else? Varasat. What about, yeah, Varasat. Yeah, what about all the celestials? Nrinam, okay. What the celestials? What is in the body of the celestials? What is sitting inside the body of the celestials? Atma. What is the truth of the very being of all celestials? Atma. Here an Atma, there an Atma, everywhere. Atma, Atma. Everything that goes oink, oink, Atma. Everything that goes moo, moo, Atma. Everything that goes quack, quack, Atma. Everything is Atma. That's what it is. That's what it is. You can just change that song. Here an Atma, there an Atma, everywhere. Atma, Atma. Old Mac Jeeva had a Jagat. This is what it is. That's all it is. So, Varasat, the truth of all, yeah, all celestials. And then what?
Ritasat.
Yeah, Ritasat. Ritam here means the, yeah, it means, no, it has a different meaning. One meaning is, karma phala. You can also take it as karma phala. Let's do that. Let's take it as karma phala. Ritam satyam uchyate avashyam bhavitvat karma phala. because we have this in the same very next chapter, Adhyaya is going to tell us, Ritam Pibantau, Sukratasya Loke, Sukratasya Ritam Pibantau. You see, Ritam is equal to Karmaphala. So here, that which sits in all the Karmaphala, the good and the bad. Ritam, Ritasat, that which is the very truth of the Karmaphala, that which transcends the Karmaphala completely. Okay? Yeah. You can also take it as the Ritam is also Yajna. Yajna tishthati. In all the fire sacrifices, that which sits in the form of Atma in every fire sacrifice, the very being of the fire sacrifice is non-separate from this Atma. Both the meanings. One is Siddhati, one is Sat. One is Sad, one is Sat. Very beautiful. Full of alliterations, full of double meanings. Very nice. Varasat, Ritasat, then? Vyomasat, very nice. Vyomni, Siddhati, Atmana, Atmarupena, Vyomni, Siddhati, Athava, what? You know? Vyomnahapi, Sat, Yaha, that which is the Sat of Vyoman. Vyoman means space. So Vyoman is space. So the truth of space. What is the truth of space? Everything I ask, one answer. Atma. The very being of space, Atma. That which sits in space, Atma. What sits in space? Here. No, here, in the example, yeah. What is something that sits in place? Sun, we already discussed. Huh? No, don't read. Just use your imagination. What sits in? Sun, we already discussed.
What else?
Moon. And then what we can see with the naked eye? Stars. Nakshatra rupena siddhanti, siddhati, nakshatra rupena siddhati, in the form of all the stars. When you see the stars, you know, a rare occurrence in Eugene in winter. But when you see the stars, you can see Atma. You can see, because it is nothing but Atma. You know, it is sitting in the stars. It is sitting as the very being of the stars. It is the very being of the stars. Vyomasat. Next one. Abja, Goja, Ritaja. So not only is the Sat of everything, it is the truth. It is born of, you know, that from which the up is born. Abja. Abja. Yeah. Abja means the, you know, it is derived, it's born in the water. Born of the waters. Abja. So what is born of water? Lotus, fishes, alligators, crocodiles, what else? Seaweed. What else is born in water? Come on, use your imagination.
Waves.
Oh, something a little more, you know, like a thing, which is for which the water is the container. We are looking at containers and things inside the container.
Viruses.
Deep sea creatures. Shells. Pearls. Ah, all those are born of water, abja, apsujayante iti abja. So everything that is born of water is what? Atma. So it is indeed born of water. So look at the paradox. Everything is born of it, but it is also in the shape of that which is born of waters. Up is a word that's always in the plural, never in the singular. So we say waters. You cannot have one water, you know. So, abja, then goja, gavi, jayate. Gavi means, you know, go means prithivi, earth. Go also means words. Go bhihi vindate, go vindha. That whose truth is found in words. What is found in words? Atma. And then abja, goja. Goja, one more meaning. The born of the earth. What is born of the earth? plants, gold, silver, clay, pot, everything is born of the earth. Trees, shrubs, creepers, everything is born of the earth. Diamonds, platinum, everything. All that is mined, all that is grown, everything is that is born of the earth. Abja, goja, and then what? Ritaja. Yeah. Also, we have to take, when we say born of the earth, we have to take barley, rice, wheat. All these are also grains that sustain the manushyas are born of the earth. Then ritaja. Ritaja means born of sacrifice, born of all the Vedangas, the sacrifices, rituals. Because we've seen the other meaning of truth and karma phala there, we also saw sacrifice there. Here, yajna also I mentioned there. Here we'll take only yajna. Born of yajna. Very nice. Risat, varasat, abja, goja, ritaja, and then what?
Adrija.
Adri means mountains. Yeah. Adribhya jayate. Born of mountains. What is born of mountains? What comes from mountains? Rivers. Rivers. So all the river bodies are what? There's nothing but Atma. So see, very clever verse. First you had contained in and then you had born off. The contained in means it's already in there. It is Siddhati sitting in and it is still Sat. It is the very presence of it is there. Its very being is the presence of that thing. And then here, born off. So even if you take on the relative Vyavaharika level, all the things which are capable of hosting a whole colony of life or whole colony of an ecosystem like the mountains and like the waters. They host a whole ecosystem, they give birth to it, the ecosystem is born out of that and resolves into that. Even when you look at it that way, in the waters, what has come out of the waters? Atma. What is the truth of the water? Atma. And here you can do something. So, jayate iti atma, you know. Jayate, and because it is sat, it as though jayate, not really jayate. Because we have already seen the sat. Sat, sat, san, sat, sat, na jayate. You know, jayate iva, ajaha, na jayate. Because previous mantra we saw the word ajaha. How can ajaha jayate? Not possible. So therefore, that's why we have to see that sat in two ways. Not just tishtati, but siddhati, but sat, the very presence of it. So what is born is mithya. Mm-hmm. But that mithya, see, wherever there is mithya, sat cannot be far behind. Why? Because mithya has no being. You just undress mithya, sat is there. Mithya is just the clothes that sat is wearing. That's what it is. You just undress it and that's all it is. You get, you know, mithya is the mask, Halloween mask, and you undress it and then what do you get? You get sat. Sat masks as, you know, mithya. Sat upholds all the mithya and that's what it is. So abja, goja, ritaja, then adrija, and then what? Ritam. Ritam comes again?
Yeah.
Adrija. Ritam here means that which is avitatha bhavaha, avitatha swabhavaha, means that which is of a non-negatable presence. Adi Shankara has something here. Avitatha swabhavaha. Sarvatma api avitatha swabhavaha eva. Therefore, ritam avitatha. Vitatha means, you know, negatable. Avitatha, you know, non-negatable. Avitatha swabhavaha, whose nature is unchanging and non-negatable, whose presence cannot be negated. You can negate David form, but you cannot negate the very presence which is donning the costume of the name and form, you cannot negate. Correct? Yeah. So therefore, ritam, not just, the word ritam is having a very nice weaving through. This is the third time it has come. First time it is ritasat, the truth of yajna, the truth of karma phala, the truth of all the relative truths that we have come to see as, the ultimate wrongly because of our, ignorance, because of the person's ignorance. Thinks yajna is everything, thinks karma phala is everything, I am under shani, I am under this, I am under that. Thinks of, all everything that is relative becomes ritam, because it is avashyam bhavi, it keeps coming back, like the karma phala. So the person also comes under the spell of thinking the relative to be absolute. First ritam. Second ritam, the yajna, sacrifice, that is also again temporary. You have to keep doing it and you get karma phala again. Correct? But the truth of that yajna, brahmarpanam brahmahavihi brahmagnav brahmanahutam brahmaivatena gantavyam brahma karma samadhina. That is, what is that truth? That which takes away all the karakas, all the, what is that, the factors involved in action, it just takes away. And that truth, is atma. And then, that was ritaja, that whatever comes out of the sacrifice is what? Atma. That's all that comes, even though you think I'm getting karma phala, but it's atma. Then finally, this rhythm is not that rhythm. This rhythm is the unchanging, non-negatable, here to stay, infinite, limitless nature, the swarupa of the word I, which is atma. And rhythm, what else? No. Briha? Brihat. Brihat. Brihat means big. That which is very, very big. The nature of the Atma is Brihat. Yeah. Totally without any limitations. Why? Sarva Karanatvat, being the cause of everything. Sarva Karanatvat, Brihat, being the cause of everything. It is indeed Brihat. Very, very important, very beautiful verse. It can be a lovely meditation. You keep chanting it. We'll chant it one more time before we close. Ham sashuchi sat.
Ham sashuchi sat.
Wait, I lost the page, so we'll start again. Ham sashuchi sat.
Ham sashuchi sat.
Vasurantariksha sat.
Vasurantariksha sat.
Hota vedishat.
Hota vedishat.
Atithir durona sat.
Atithir durona sat.
Nrishat.
Nrishat.
Parasat.
Parasat.
Ritasat.
Ritasat.
Vyomasat.
Vyomasat.
Abja goja ritaja.
Adrija,
Ritam Brihat,
Ritam Brihat,
Om Purnamadav,
Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnudachyate, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnamivavashishyate, Om Shanti, Shanti, Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Guru Yo Namaha. Harihi Om.